Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंदगंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
Today's first question is from Induja. During the meditation process, many people experience Kundalini awakening and levitation and many other experiences. But I don't get levitation experiences or other experiences. I can only feel the energy. Why is it, Swami? Am I doing the meditations wrong or is something wrong with me? Induja, Chennai, Tamil Nadu, India.
Induja, nothing is wrong with you. Except the expectation. It is the expectation and the ideas you carry. Only that is something wrong. Other than that, nothing is wrong with you. You are asking, during the meditation process, many people experience Kundalini awakening and levitation. Many other experiences. But I don't get levitation. Experiences are other experiences. So, you are saying, I can feel the energy. I can only feel the energy. Means, even if I send so much energy, Lifting you is a little difficult task. You are asking, why is it? Understand? We have done some scientific researches on this also. Physically, when you levitate, at least you can say, hey, because of the physical movement, some brain waves are changing. This one is not even physically moving, but the brain waves are changing the moment I show the hand. This proves in everybody, brain waves change only because of my energy, not because of physical movement. Because some of the doctors were saying, no. Maybe because they are jumping, the brain waves are changing. So Induja, surely you have a strong feeling connection with me, no doubt. That's why you are feeling the energy. So body lifting or levitation, don't worry about it. Don't bother about it. What needs to happen in you is happening. See, the purpose of Kundalini awakening is not you jumping. Jumping is just a side effect. The real purpose is transforming you. You evolving to the next level. Transforming your being. I tell you, it's the best thing can happen to you. So, you don't need to jump. Just you feeling the energy and transforming yourself is more than enough. You are on the right track. Neither you are doing something wrong, nor something is wrong with you, except this comparison. Modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis. I have created a 1-year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya yoga practices to create healthy body. Spiritual discourses to develop mental health. Meditations that help balance emotions. Kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering. Opportunity to express leadership qualities. Techniques that improve creative skills. Learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads, in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny, or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biddi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
The next question, Dhyanandam Swamiji, can you elaborate a little bit on the mechanics of Ajapa Japa? Recently, in the past 1.5 months, I started repeating a verse from Saundarya Lahari in the Ajapa Japa style, going round and round in my throat. Is this okay, or is it best to repeat Soham or Om Hrim Nityanandaya Namaha for Ajapa Japa? Thank you very much for everything, Srikant. I graduate.
Srikant, first thing, you can use anything for ajapa japa. It does not need to be just soham or guru mantra or ishta mantra. Anything is okay. See, if you feel connected to Devi, then repeat Saundarya Lahari, perfectly all right. What mantra you repeat is not a problem at all. The consciousness, intention and the way you repeat is the main thing. I'll repeat what is ajapa japa. Japa means just the voice coming from the navel through the tongue leaving. A continuous linear movement of air getting converted to sound is japa. Like Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namo Narayana. You say so many mantras, Om Reem Nityanandayana, Om Soham Arsivoham. So many mantras are there. You can even chant Saundarya Lahari. Anything is okay. What you chant is not a problem at all. That is not a very important thing. How you chant? Unfortunately, when you are chanting like a japa, means sound leaving, you only become more and more unconscious, more and more unaware. But when the ajapa japa means the in the throat, sound moving in this direction, circular direction. Visualize. See, in the initial level, visualization is enough. If you are chanting the Maha Mantra, if you are chanting the Shiva Mantra, if you are chanting the Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, anything, any mantra is okay. I'll sincerely recommend all of you guys carry like this on prayer wheel. In the initial level, for first 21 days, you carry like this on prayer wheel and train yourself, just like this prayer wheel. See, when this prayer wheel rotates, in this, the mantra is written, in this prayer wheel, there is a mantra written, Om Mani Padmeham. So, Om Mani Padmeham, how it is rotating, just like the same way in your throat that Om Mani Padmeham rotates. But now when you want to chant Namah Shivaya or Om Reem Nitya, whatever mantra you want to chant, just put it in a paper, small slip you write and paste it on this prayer wheel. And use this prayer wheel. Visualize just like this prayer wheel in your throat the mantra is moving. In a circular way. Om Namah Shivaya, 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 Om Namah Shivaya. Whatever mantra you are using, Soham, Soham. I can see now very clearly in my throat only it is going this way. Not even 1 inch is coming this way. So feel the mantra is like a ring fixed on your vocal cord. This way, Om Namah Shivaya, 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 Om Namah Shivaya. Visualize the this prayer wheel will really help you guys for visualization. I'll sincerely recommend if you want to master ajapa japa, have a prayer wheel like this, one prayer wheel, and paste the mantra you want to visualize, meditate on this prayer wheel. Put a small paper and paste it. With this, constantly repeat. In the initial days, take it up like a 21 day practice. For the 21 days, have this continuously, whole day and night, whenever you can find time. Keep this always next to you. If you are having 3 minutes break in your work, you work only once in a while. Why are you lying? Now in the mind you say, no, 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 I work too. No. So when you are having the break in the work, means 24 hours. Pick up this wheel and go on repeating. Om Namah Shivaya, 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 Namah Shivaya. Whatever mantra you are using, you can use any mantra. Whatever mantra you are using, just continuously let the mantra go on inside you, I tell you.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
Will lead you to the very spicy enlightenment. Understand? Even in unclutching, after a few minutes, you feel bored, tired, and stop unclutching without even your knowledge. But first 1 month, 2 months, if you practice this ajapa ajapa, you learn the process of locking yourself in the throat, then getting into inside your inner space and unclutching is very easy. It is really very easy. So use this prayer wheel. Just chanting, Namah Shivaya, 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 Namah Shivaya. Continuously use this prayer wheel, and it's really powerful. I tell you, it's really, really powerful. It is more powerful than the Japamala. Even in Japamala, again and again, visually you learn only the linear movements. But with this, you learn the circular movements. You learn the true movement, the way the japa has to happen. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Whatever mantra you are using. Om Hrim Nityanandeshwaraya Namaha. Om Hrim Nityanandeshwaraya Namaha. Om Hrim Nityanandeshwaraya Namaha. Whatever mantra you are using, use this. Actually, this leads to the right visualization. And mantra will be continuously rotating inside your walk. Actually, I can sit like this even whole day. One of the greatest thing can happen to a seeker is getting addicted to mantra. I tell you, that's the most sweetest thing. You will be liberated from all patterns. Of course, you can never use the word addiction for mantra. De-addiction, that's the right word. You will be de-addicted from everything. Very young age, very... At the age of 7 or 8, I was addicted to the mantra. I was initiated into Shodasi, means the 16th syllable of Devi. It's called Shodashakshari. By the Kuppammal, she initiated me, Mata Vibhudanandapuri. I'll just repeat the mantra like anything. Just my whole body became mantra maya. Means vibrating, reverberating with that mantra. Then, what happens, you know, in the Shodasakshari, when you chant and when your whole body becomes mantra maya, your chakras, energy centers become alive. And from there, that Panchakshari starts coming out. Panchakshari is not supposed to be chanted. Panchakshari is Namah Shivaya. That's not supposed to be chanted by you. It should come out of your energy centers when your body becomes mantramaya. You chant any mantra, finally Panchakshari will come out of you. When Panchakshari comes out of you, your body has become mantramaya. Not you chanting the Panchakshari, understand? You starting Namashivaya, Namashivaya, Namashivaya does not mean you become mantramaya. No. You may start with Soham or Om Reem Nityanandaya Namaha or Om Reem Nityanandeshwaraya Namaha or Shodasi or Saundarya Lahari, whatever you may start, your body will be processed by the mantra. Anything you pick up, finally that Namashivaya mantra will come by itself from your chakras. It's actually the Namashivaya is the bija of each chakra. Each chakra's bija is the Namashivaya mantra. It will come out of your body by itself. Then you become mantramaya. Actually, even now, if I don't have this nonsensical work of running this mission, organization, I'll just sit under banyan tree in front of our Anandeshwara, go on, I'll be just happy to sit and chant the mantra, do ajapa japa and sit my whole life. Sometimes I wonder, better I can just sit in front of Anandeshwara. I don't need anything else for my life, for me to be happy, or for me to be blissful. I don't need anything else. Just give me one prayer wheel and give me 2 meals and I'll sit in front of Anandeshwara whole day. Just chanting, and this Anandeshwara also I made exactly as I saw. Means my own vision. Exactly as I saw, including the jewelries. So I'll be happy to sit whole day and gaze at him. Gaze at him and be in that mood of Namashivaya, 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 over. Actually, just like a honeycomb when you...
क्या आप स्वयं एक अवतार पुरुष से अपने जीवन में दिव्य मार्गदर्शन चाहते हैं? प्रस्तुत करते हैं अवतार पुरुष से वार्ता।
नित्यानंदम, नित्यानंदा हियर।
परमहंस नित्यानंदा संसार को एक और अतुल्य और अनोखी भेंट दे रहे हैं।
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
अब वो लाइव किसी के भी प्रश्नों का उत्तर स्वयं देंगे.
That's great. No, you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
8 से प्रारंभ. कुछ सौभाग्यशाली लोग जो 0800-27-27-9999 पर फोन करेंगे, वो स्वयं स्वामी जी से बात कर सकते हैं. लाइव देखें एनटीवी पर ntv.nityananda.org. जस्ट एन आवर्स ड्राइव फ्रॉम बैंगलोर, एशियाज फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग सिटी इज अ यूनिक स्पेस ऑफ हीलिंग, मेडिटेशन एंड रिजुविनेशन. वेलकम टू नित्यानंद ध्यानपीठम. Experience soothing healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biddi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
Actually, just like a honeycomb, when you touch the honeycomb, how the honey oozes, like that. When I chant that achapa achapa, the nectar oozes from the throat. I can just be sitting whole day with that nectar. Nothing else is required. Achapa achapa releases certain kind of a energy from your body. Your body also will have tremendous energy, and the energy will flow into others also. It's really powerful. Sometimes I used to do the achapa achapa sitting in the banks of Ganges in Varanasi and in Calcutta. Whole day Ganga flowing and you are in achapa achapa, nothing else is required for your life. I don't know why fools, people are wasting their life and time in so many nuisance and unnecessary things. Nothing more is required. Just sit in the banks of Ganges, be in achapa achapa, life is heaven. Anyhow, if I tell all these people think I am fool, achapa achapa is one of the most powerful process, most powerful technique. And achapa achapa will give you siddhis, not just enlightenment. It will give you a lot of powers also, because the sakti sanchalana happens through achapa achapa. Sakti sanchalana means constantly your kundalini is awakened, but never allowed to go out of your body. It stays inside the body. So achapa achapa is very powerful process. Whatever you want to do in your life, use achapa achapa. Anyhow, but you will have a lot of powers, siddhis, through achapa achapa.
The next question is from Ma Dhanalakshmi from Singapore. Swamiji, can you please explain what are the benefits of attending Inner Awakening again? I am planning to attend Inner Awakening in April for the second time. Ma Dhanalakshmi from Singapore.
Dhanalakshmi from Singapore. First thing, Ma, if you ask me, what is the benefit of drinking the nectar again? What can I answer? First thing, you will enjoy again. Second thing, you will become more strong, more alive. Here you are asking about an inner awakening. What is the benefits of attending the IA again? First thing, you may not have completely gone through when you attend only once. Second time when you attend only, you will understand how many sessions you missed. So it really strengthens your spiritual growth. I can say IA is not ending, it is beginning. IA is not ending, it is beginning. Understand? I tell you, Dhanalakshmi, more and more at IAs you attend, naturally the more spiritual growth, more stronger unclutching experience, more spiritual powers and experiences. Not only you, I am also attending more and more IAs. That is why I am expressing more and more powers. I understand, every IA, it's not that you are only sitting unclutched. During that time, what will I do? I also just sit unclutched. So more and more energy is expressing through my body. More and more good things are happening. So more IA means more spiritual awakening. That's all. Welcome. Come to the April Inner Awakening. Welcome.
The next question is from Jamie Wilson. She is asking, Dear Swamiji, we have been doing Nitya Dhyan in the morning, Satsang each evening, and ending with Shakti Dharana meditation. Is this a good routine, or would a different meditation or Kriya be better for 2012? Do some people absorb healing energy more than others? The other day, I did the healing on a woman and immediately the energy was very intense and she saw a vision of you. Please explain, Jamie Wilson.
Jamie Wilson, she's sending a beautiful experience. We have been doing Nitya Dhyan in the morning, Satsang, each evening and ending with Shakti Dharana meditation. Is this a good routine? Jamie Wilson, perfect routine. Do that, no problem. Or would a different meditation or Kriya be better for 2012? No. This is enough. When you are going to do the 2012 meditation, only on that day, on those days, use the 2012 meditation, 2012 Kriya. Other times, this is best. Nitya Dhyana and Shakti Dharana is perfect. And he's asking some people absorb healing energy more than others. The other day I did the healing on a woman, immediately the energy was very intense and she saw a vision of you. Jamie Wilson, it is true. That lady must have been already connected to me, waiting for you to touch her and awaken my presence in her, my happening in her life. I can say she was just waiting, ready. You did the right thing. Some people really do receive more energy. Blessings.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nithyananda. Nithyananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social-emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious Program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings.
Next question is from Ananda Sadajit from Walnut Cove, North Carolina. She's asking, Dear Swamiji, I am wondering why you want us to take neem continuously. Most herbs after some time will have done their job and the healing is complete. I have been taking neem almost continuously for a year and a half and was just wondering if it is something different from other healing herbs.
Sadajit, I wanted you to know main thing. Neem is like a food. It is not just a herb alone. It's a food also. So that is the reason I want you to take neem every day, because neem cleanses your stomach, intestine, every day. Every day it cleanses. It cleanses. So that's the reason I wanted neem to be taken every day. It is not just herb alone. It's a food also. All right.
The next question is from Anne Cassin from Paris. She is asking, Swamiji, some devotees cannot watch morning satsang live at 3 a.m. in France. Nevertheless, they do listen to the translation on Ustream next day. Does listening to the discourse the next day have the same effect as when watched live? Do we integrate the truth deeply when we listen to the discourse the next day as well, Swamiji? Thank you. From Anne Cassin, Paris.
Because no other way, next day is okay. But when you listen live, that entanglement, energy entanglement also happens. That's why I recommend listening live more. And moreover, now I have started a new satsangs, especially for European devotees. For your convenience, I am doing the satsang in the evening, 7 o'clock Indian Standard Time also. I started every Saturday, Sunday. I'll be doing evening 7 o'clock. For European devotees, use that chance and enjoy. Other days, at least watch the recorded discourse, the translation. You will have the great truths assimilating into you. But the nothing like watching live. Okay. At least next option.